actually work on the escape, the trap and roll escape. Now with this one, we're gonna work on the basic part of it first, and then we're gonna talk about the different variations that we can find ourselves in.
Here from the mount position, if I have my hands based on the ground, then she's going to reach over and she's going to trap my arm in. When she has my arm trapped in, if I'm trying to pull it out, she has it trapped up against her body, so I cannot pull it out that way. Now, after trapping my arm, she's gonna reach up with her foot and trap my foot on the same side. So arm and foot on the same side. From there, she's gonna bridge her hips up, which is gonna take my balance away. Then she's gonna roll me in that position.
Okay, once we land, she's gonna have one hand on my solar plexus, one hand on my knee, and then she's going to push down my solar plexus knee in order to help her stand up.
So now from another angle, she reaches over, traps the arm, traps the foot, bridges her hips up in the air, and rolls.
Now, brace and stand up.
So from here again, reaches over, traps, traps, bridges, and rolls.
So from this position, when I am not in mount position on her, what she is doing is she's actually going to bridge her hips up this way, as high as she can, then she rolls all the way over to her knees. You want to make sure that you roll all the way to your knees. If you do not roll all the way to your knees, then this is going to give them the opportunity to jump right back into mount. Now we're going to show you some examples at full speed with this one. So what we want to do in this situation is make sure that you're practicing that basic part over and over again until you are able to do that with no problems. Then, once you have that, we're going to move on to these different variations.
So for our first variation is when they're sitting on top of you and now they're trying to strike at you. In this position, she does not want to stay here entirely too long, because if she stays here too long, eventually a punch is going to catch through. And once that first one catches through, then more are going to be able to hit you. So as fast as she can, what she wants to do after blocking is going to be to bridge her hips up to drive my hands to the floor. Once my hands hit the floor, then she's going to go ahead and go right through what we've done before. Trap, trap, bridge, and roll. So now we're punching. Block, 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 bridge, trap, trap, and roll. And now punching, bridge, trap, trap, and roll. So now if I'm choking her this way, she's going to reach across and grab my wrist on that side, keeping my arm from coming away from her neck, and now she's going to grab my tricep on the same side. From there, she's going to trap my foot, and now she bridges and rolls. Now she's going to reach across to trap the wrist, reach up to grab the tricep, and trap my foot, bridge, and roll. One more time, trap the wrist, trap the tricep, trap the foot, bridge and roll.
Now obviously with this one we need to move quickly. If someone's choking you like this, you have between 5 and 8 seconds before you would actually pass out. So you want to make sure that that trap for your wrist and the tricep goes at the same time and very, very quickly. You'll notice here when we actually are doing it at full speed.
Now from this position, they would have you under the head with a headlock, reaching out and basing out. There are some advantages that you have to this position, but there also are some advantages they have. For one thing, they have all their weight on the opposite side. But for one thing for you is they already have trapped their arm for you. So she just reaches up, grabs in tight on the arm, not letting my arm go. And now she's gonna trap the leg and bridge up and go on that side. So again, from here, they have the headlock here. She traps, traps the foot, bridge, roll. Here, headlock. Now, if you need an extra boost from here, you can always take this arm and push up into the armpit or push on the chest as you go. this one we call the bully mount. That is when your arms are pinned to the ground just like this. What you need to do is get both of your hands to one side. And simply that is by, from this position, moving both arms over. So if she tries to bench press me up, it's not going to work. And now she shifts both arms to one side. She traps the foot on that side and she bridges and rolls. So again, from here, she wants to shift both of her arms to one side. She traps the foot on that side. She bridges and rolls. And last time, shifts both hands to that side, traps on that side, bridges and rolls. Make sure that once you shift your arms to one side, you're immediately trapping the foot, bridging and rolling. If you shift your arms to one side and then hesitate, that's going to give them the opportunity to pull your arms back into the bully mount. Make sure you practice each one of these variations until you're very comfortable with each one on both sides as